Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome back to another episode of Muv Luv Alternative. Last time we started, Takeru got sent to, he either went back in time or got sent to like an exact or really similar reality, which I think is more likely because he already went to another reality, but we will see in time probably. So yeah, he went in, He played the first day a little differently. Instead of getting imprisoned, he managed to talk with Yuko, and they've kind of come to an understanding already. So this saves us. I don't know how many days he's been in prison. Was it like 5? So this already like helps, and yeah, it's gonna be more focused on helping Yuko achieve the Alternative 4 plan, rather than the whole training arc and stuff that you go through in Unlimited. I'm sure we'll still train, but Takeru, like, his, not just his memory, but it also his, like, physical fitness levels, transferred over. So he's went through the training arc already. Now it's all just gravy on top. Now, honestly, now if he does the disguise of, hey, I'm a super special agent, he'll actually, like, be more of a fit for it, because he actually has the skills to back it up. But yeah, let's continue our chat with Yuko, and maybe we'll see some of the other cast this episode. Speaking of which, she was talking about her gun, by the way.
Nani?
Well, if I recall correctly, you've never had firearms training.
Mahara.
Volume's fine, okay. If you want to try to use a 9mm without training, there's no way you'll hit your target, not even from this distance and using both your hands. It's probably true. I have never fired a gun myself. I live in Canada, so guns are a lot less common. I don't even know if we probably do have a firing range somewhere. Maybe, but I'm not even sure. Maybe we don't. We're not gun-pilled. We fight with love and kindness. Or so the world thinks, but in reality, we bomb you with maple syrup. Leave you all sticky. No, I was just too tense to... I was way too tense to think of that. It only just occurred to me. Sure. Yeah, basically, I guess. Yep. Imagine she's the same. What is it? She didn't really even tell us about the room next door. We just wandered in there one day. I think it might have been because I wasn't from this world to begin with. Yeah, it's a chill world. My memory's a little fuzzy at this point, but yes, I come from a world without beta, or at least that's what I believed. The world I was born and raised in was nowhere near as horrific as this one. And you were a teacher at school. It was a peaceful world, no beta, no nothing. I mean, there's probably still wars, but obviously it's not as bad as an alien invasion. The good old days. Well, no, there were still wars between humans. But even then, it was a far cry from a total worldwide crisis like this. Peaceful, huh? Now there's a word I've gained a newfound respect for lately. In fact, Yuko-sensei, who really got me thinking about it, when she pointed out that most of the world wasn't like Japan. But I'm back, sorry. I got a pop-up like, Epic Games, claim your free game. Which, you got a fireman. I know people like, why use Epic Games when Steam exists? Bro, they give a free game every week. It's just value. I'm collecting, man. I've never bought a game there, and I have like, 100 games, at least, on Epic. It's pretty sick. Would recommend. Yeah, we said this, right? Oh yeah, and a lot of the people I met in this world also existed in mine, and while their personalities were the same, their circumstances were very different. This building was my high school, not a military base. You and Marimo-chan were my teachers there, and the surface pilot cadets were my classmates. Nope. Maybe. Huh? Nope, I don't think so. Is that what it's called, Everett? Yep, multiverse shit. I can't speak to the science behind it, but that does sound about right. Yeah, just one thing though. My childhood friend Kagami Sumika wasn't in the previous version of this world.
Kagami Sumika.
Yeah, you told me that she didn't exist in any of your databases. Then you said I should just forget all about her, or I'd look like a sissy or something like that. So at this point, I totally get why you had to say that. People have a totally different way of thinking here. I guess he doesn't remember the final chat with Kasumi and how he thought that she might be Sumika. So anyway, because that happens in like all the endings. I guess except for the Kozuki ending. So anyway, you took an interest in me, and said I was gonna assist you in your research. I never actually found out. You just called me down here from time to time and asked me questions about my world. Eventually, you granted me a special off-the-book security clearance so I could access this floor at will. Which is why I was able to get Kasumi on that shuttle. Okay, so he literally does remember that scene. Actually. Oh, but you didn't give me authorization to access any classified information. I probably could have lied about that one, but it's not worth the risk now that you finally started to believe me. Honestly? Maybe you shouldn't have lied. That would be some valuable tech. I need to be completely honest with her. It's a little white lie. I guess it doesn't make sense to you either, huh? I never really understood it myself. Honestly, what do you think of your plan was? Oh, but the stuff about semiconductors, you just told me that when you were drunk. I didn't make a point of asking you about it or anything. No, we like wandered in one day. Come to think of it, no, all you ever did was make a one-off joke about Kasumi being your daughter. So. Yep. Yeah, and we were the top pilot all around her, anyways. There were some better ones at specific things. That's right, you gave me a place to stay here. I was a member of Cadet Squad 207. Nice. Sensei, like I said before, we really don't have time for that. Well, you still need like, if you're gonna be living on the base, you still need like some sort of cover. I guess you can say that he's a research assistant, but I don't know. I'll never make it in time if you start over from scratch. Welp. I know. Alright then. Cool. We'll take it. It's not even dark out yet. I figured it would be a lot later by now. Oh, are we gonna meet, I guess it would be Ayamne this time, because that was our last finished route. It took a little doing, but it looks like I've made my way back into Squad 207. And I even got the same security pass to boot, meaning I've got unrestricted access to B-19F. Judging from Sensei's attitude, she seems even more interested in me than last time. Which makes sense, because I know that this time is much more valuable to her. Alright, this is where the real fight begins. No matter what it takes, have to see alternative 4 to completion. Man, it would have been nice to stop here last video, but yeah. Whatever. Like, this is a, I don't know, it feels like an epic thing, and then they're gonna cut to the opening, right? Not that I have the slightest idea what I can possibly do to help with that. Still, Yuto-sensei knows what needs to be done, she just didn't make it in time, is all. I just have to make sure she meets the deadline this time around. But how the hell am I supposed to do that? I'm gonna have to figure out something out and fast. Let's see, what can I do to help? Well, we need to know what she's doing. It's kind of hard to theorize. Hello. Tayamne, right? Huh? Oh, are you talking to me? Yep. Ah. Hello. Friendo. Well, imagine that. Wouldn't have expected Kay to go out of her way to warn a total stranger that he's wandering into a restricted area. That's one for the record books. Huh? Well, wait, what the hell? Why did I call her Kay in my head just now? Pretty sure I never called Ayamne by her first name. Cursed existence? Should have cleared the timer out before starting? No, I'm joking. It is what it is. I like Kay. Even though she's... If you put a gun to my head and made me rank the characters, I'd probably put her last. But I still like her. She actually has one of my favorite character designs, like just purely off appearance. And I also got this weird fuzzy feeling for a second there. Not sure if that it's just nostalgia or what. Oh, sorry. What's up? Oh no, actually I'm why does this feel so impersonal, I wonder? Cause she doesn't know you? I mean, Ayamne was always a bit standoffish, right?
Ayamne, Inda.
Remo? Remo-chan, it's been so long. I haven't seen you in years. Oh yeah, she went up in the shuttle. Yep. Oh, now meet everyone. The gang. Huh? Where's Mikoto? Alright, she's still in the hospital. My name's Shirogane Takeru. Nice to meet you all. Look at that. Look at the day. Look at Tama's determined face right there. Why is she so serious? I forgot, what was the explanation for that? Because most of the men just died in the front lines or something. Yeah, it's complicated. Anyway, it's good to meet you all.
とりあえずは一緒に食事でもして早く交流を深めることだ。榊、食事の後、弊社への案内などもろもろ頼んだぞ。はい。では残り10分、引き続き訓練だ。白金は少し見学していろ。Understood.
So they're just doing laps, huh? I remember panting like a dog when they first made me run 10 clits. Then everyone started giving me shit for it. Well, mostly just last rep. Whoa, wait a sec. If time's the only thing that's been reset and my body's still the same as it used to be, that means I'm not gonna be holding the others back once training starts tomorrow. Yep. Given how I handled myself in that little scrap at the front gate, running 10 clits should be a piece of cake. So then, does that mean we could all graduate faster if you play our cards right? Is that how it works? Because the final test is like at a set date, unless you can like make them give it to you earlier. Rad Habanod. That was the last thing the base CEO said to me back when I was begging him to tell us what the alternative program actually was. At the end of the day, we were only cadets. It didn't matter how noble our intentions were, or how noble they were literally, because they were, most of the people were like related to someone important, or how desperately we wanted to protect our planet and its people, none of it made a lick of difference without the rank and authority to back it up. That was one hard pill to swallow. This country is looking for every surface pilot it can get. The only reason we weren't sent to the front lines was because Alternative 5 was put into effect, and that changed everything. Yeah, keeping all their manpower to make sure they got safely off of Earth. Maybe we just had to get commissioned. Right, once we graduate, Yuto Sensei can assign us to missions that'll help Alternative 4 move forward. We'll have access to more intel. The information I have can be put to better use, and people might even listen to us. Everything would change. Alright then, I think that's settled. For now, my number one objective is to graduate as soon as humanly possible. Once I get commissioned, I'll have a little bit more to say around here, and that might come in handy if I'm gonna be a play in any of Yuto Sensei's plans. This is an interesting perspective. It definitely takes like a different like feel in terms of storytelling. When the classic I'm looping, let me play it differently with the knowledge I have. It's kind of funny. A lot of the things, like projects on the channel are like looping stories, like Higurashi. Everything's looping, man. All the time. I like them, but it's uncanny almost. And it's all and it's always unintentional. Like, I'm pretty sure there's a handful of series that have to do with time loops or multiverse stuff. We might even be able to mate some other allies of our own. Yes, get Kashiwagi. She didn't appear in Unlimited. We need our goated goalkeeper. She will save us all. I should have asked Yuto Sensei more about Alternative 4. Also true. What could have caused her plans to fail? I bet she's struggling with the adapting problem right now. You can't help if you don't know what we're helping with. In any case, I saw how this played out in the end, and I want to find some way to make the people upstairs listen to me. If they don't start making some serious changes, that tragedy is just going to repeat itself. In order to prevent that, I have to earn their trust somehow. This is so damn frustrating. If only I had more people on my side. No, I'm sick and tired of making excuses. The fate of the Earth and all mankind is on the line here. I don't have time to whine. I'm the one who's lived through it, and I'm the one who's got to do something about it. And I'm going to get everyone else on board, whether they like it or not. Alright, then it's settled. There's one thing that's kind of bugging me, though. I keep racking my brain over this, but I can't remember why I feel so strongly about this. About all of this. Finding a way back to my world was my top priority up until that Christmas. The only thing that kept me going was the hope that I'd find some way home eventually, right? In that case, why was I so devastated when the CEO told me it was all for naught? I still remember just how outraged and powerless I felt, like it was yesterday. I think that the moment I came in terms with the fact that I was probably going to remain in this world till the day I died. But I can't remember why I suddenly felt okay with that. Was there some sort of catalyst that changed my perspective? Yeah, you fell in love with various heroines. Could it be that after living alongside these people who had to fight every day for survival, I eventually started to feel like one of them? Right. Maybe we should be less conspicuous though. Aww. What's the big deal, class rep? It just means I did a good job studying beforehand. Whoops. Sorry about that. You just looked so much like my class representative from high school, that's all. I've gotta stop acting all buddy-buddy with her. If I burn my bridges here, we're screwed. Our unity as a team has a huge impact on morale and our ability to perform. Damn, it's really tough figuring out where to draw the line. Who? What's her name? I always forget her name, because it starts with a K and I immediately think of Kozuki. Lunch lady! Koyozuka! Oh hey, it's Miss Koyozuka. Have you ever seen this POV? New POV just dropped? Aw man, this is such a trip. I haven't seen her since the base was repossessed and repurposed for Alternative 5. Where did she go? She didn't make it to the shuttle, did she? So she's here too, huh? Yeah, of course she would be. Oh, maybe she did. I mean, good for her if she did. Enlistment oath, I shall fulfill my duty to maintain international peace and order. Oh yeah, this thing. I do kind of remember having to recite this now that I think about it. Huh? Oh no, I just heard about it from a friend of mine who wanted to join the UN forces. Yep. What is it? Sure, what's up? True. We are special. Right.
それは私たち、いえ、ひいてはこの国の、この星のためになる特別なのよね。
Yeah, that's the plan, at least.
それは頼もしいな。頑張りましょうね、白金さん。Yeah, let's.
And this time, we'll actually show them. Right from the start. Oh, I get it now. They were like this back then too. At the time, I had no idea what they were asking about. Absolutely. It's like the culmination of all our basic training, so we can't afford to fail. I've just heard a lot about it, is all. I feel like we should be less suspicious, but I don't know. You do you, Takeru.
それに先んじて、あと1週間もすれば鎧も戻ってくるはずだ。その時には、207小隊を最強のチームにしておきたいものだ。ヨロイさんは訓練中に怪我をして、今入院中なんです。様々な方面、特にサバイバルに関しては、右に出るものがいないわね。
Though I'm guessing this time in the island, we probably are not gonna get poisoned. I see, can't wait to meet her. Again. Sure thing, just go easy on me, alright? As we lap them in training. when I saw the gym, I thought we were about to play basketball for some reason. Whoa! He's reading. I already missed the first part. We can just imagine me reading this. Okay. I feel weird starting the scene. Speech halfway through. It's me! Did we see that before? Salut! Look at this. Well-groomed boy. Bright yellow eyes. Huff, huff, huff. Instructor, I'm done. Damn, we actually lapped him. I told it, man. No, I think I'll run a few more laps while I wait. Damn, get owned. See, now we look at the special Cadet or whatever. It actually goes with our cover. Yep, looks like my stamina hasn't gone down one bit. I guess it's kind of weird that I expected anything different, but it seems that my body's just as strong as it used to be. I don't think it's weird. I would honestly expect it to if I went back in time or looped or something. Usually you don't carry over your stats, just memory. In the typical kind of story. Which basically means that if I did the same workload as everyone else, I'd only get weaker. Ooh. We jogged in. Okay. Bye. Damn, that's a lot of running. Tama, get her some water. Wait, what? We're not doing full gear? Relax, Takeru. Not everyone's juiced up like you. Oh crap, I probably shouldn't have said that. Okay, I guess we're gonna be. We're gonna be in full gear. No, I just meant. Oh no. I guess he wants to, but. Gah! I mean, they're about as heavy as the real one, so it's not that much added weight, but they're really awkward to lug around. Understood! Alright, up we go. There, that ought to do it. Tama! What do you mean? Those sleeves are way too big for her, man. They need to tailor her uniform properly. Oh, I mean, it's no big deal. Oh wow, listen to me, all high and mighty. Now I know how the others must have felt back when I almost coughed up a lung trying to keep up at first. Man, I really weighed those guys down. I mean, we're all gonna have to run 20 in full gear sooner or later, you know? Sorry, but I can't really afford to slack off here. Phew. Finally, I can take a break. In my current condition, I can run however many laps they want me to. No sweat. But the fact that it's so easy for me is also a little concerning. Are the others gonna be able to manage, I hope? No matter how well I do, it won't mean a thing if the others can't keep up. We're being evaluated as a team here, not as individuals. Maybe this is how class rep felt back when I was the one holding the team back. Well, it's certainly not brand new, and it still smells like someone else's room, but... Welp, looks like I'm home. Should I really be calling it that, though? I mean, you're living there. I guess this place feels a lot more like home than my actual house did when I woke up there yesterday. Though I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. If I were to save the world and then somehow be given the opportunity to return to my own, I honestly have no idea whether I'd want to stay or leave. So like, doesn't that mean I'm already content with the idea of spending the rest of my life here? Back then, I always figured that no matter how hard the decision might be, I'd still end up going back to my world in the end. But now? Well, sitting around overanalyzing things isn't gonna do me any good. Maybe I should go outside and get some fresh air. It's already nighttime, but it's still pretty warm out. Man, I remember coming around here around Christmas. We were basically training in a full-on blizzard half the time. There was nothing blocking the wind, so it just felt like you could be blown away at any time. Anyway, I probably shouldn't wander off too far, so let's just go for a short jog. Oh, looks like someone here. Is it still Ayame? Tama? Ayame. Meia! Whoops. Oh, hey Meia. Sorry, I mean... Sorry, manners aren't really my strong suit, I guess. I'll work on it. Alright. Anyway, what are you up to? Maybe she's been inspired by our performance? You're being punished for something? Oh, never mind. She just does it on the regular. Oh, yeah. Right, I do kind of remember having this conversation last time. I don't. About her doing extra laps. Yep, we've definitely had this conversation before. I do remember that line. And why is that? Huh? Mind if I ask what that might be? I see. Yeah, I learned all too well just how much her country means to her during the incident at the volcano.
Hmm?
Yeah, I do. The Earth and all mankind. Ha! You want to protect Japan? I'm gonna one-up you. Oh, not that I'm trying to one-up you or anything. Yeah, that's what it sounded like. It's funny. Okay. You think so? I mean, it is. I feel like if you, like, non-ironically, or not, like, fully actually, like, your goal was to protect the Earth, it is, like, pretty amazing. I feel like in most cases... people are, like, pretty selfish, and I don't even think of that as a bad thing. Like, I think individually, like, on an inner level, like, I'm selfish in the fact that, like, I don't really care too much about people I don't know. Like, I just, you know, there's, like, levels to, like, you care about your family, your friends, and then, like, the people of my city, not so much. But to, like, non-ironically, like, be super selfless... feel like that takes a lot, shows a lot of character. I'm just not that type of person, just being completely honest. And it's not embarrassing at all either. Oh, cut it out. Well, at first I was trying to get by, but now, yeah, I guess you're right.
Yeah,
people can accomplish great things when they have a driving purpose. I learned them from you, Meia. Don't say that. She doesn't know. Come on, bro. Oh, crap. Gotta change the subject. Oh, whoops. I just used your first name again, didn't I? My bad. Oh, I was just trying to go for a little jog to try to clear my head. Damn, we're already bonding hard with Meia. Yeah, I'd like that. Have a nice night then. Later. People can accomplish great things when they have a driving purpose. Yeah, that it is a little nice saying. Nice little saying. Yeah. Man, I really have learned a lot from these guys. I wonder why I never paid more attention. I should really take all this stuff to heart. Let's do a few laps, then stop by Yuko-sensei's office. That'll meet Kasumi. For introducing everyone. Our little bunny alarm clock. Excuse me. Actually, I guess we meet her later, usually, but... Oh, she's... We're snooping. Is this a bad time? I was waiting for her to say ciao, man. Come on. Should I come back later? I've made up my mind. I'm gonna graduate and become a surface pilot as soon as possible. So that you and everyone else will start taking me seriously. I can't do anything as a cadet. I want to become a real service pilot as soon as possible, so I can have more of a say around here. What a cadet says will never be taken as seriously as what a base CO says, even if they're saying the exact same things. I mean, true. I don't know if we're gonna make CO, honestly. Whatever, I'm gonna graduate the training academy and become a real soldier before you know it.
We knew a little bit, but we didn't go into great detail. Yes. Well, besides Tama, we cured her anxiety.
You can count on me, ma'am. And what would that be?
Zero.
Literally nothing besides the fact that it has to do something with the multiverse, which I don't even know if Takeru realized that. Huh?
Well,
that's because... All I know about Alternative 4 are the most basic, non-specific details. Yeah, like what? Like I said before, I know you're in charge of the project and that it's one of the reasons this base even exists in the first place, or rather, the real reason. It's the brain tubes they found underneath in the intro. And that you need to find a way to fit a 15 billion semiconducting parallel computing circuits in the palm of your hand. And that the Surface Pilot Cadet Squad 207 was a part of that plan. And that by December 24th, you've had the entire theory all worked out, but that your peers told you it'd never work. Actually, I remember you saying something like, I wasn't cut out to be the Holy Mother. I don't know, but it was right after you said that Christmas was the day up which a single child bestowed a new hope onto mankind. I think it had something to do with that. Let's see. Well, you said there was a UN military insignia on Kasumi's shoulder and said Alternative 4, so I figured that brain might have something to do with it. Alright, there were people trying to sabotage Alternative 4, though I don't really know how or why. That's about it, really. Did we really dive into that? Maybe we did, like, at the beginning of Unlimited. I don't really remember that. Talking about anti-alternative people. Oh yeah, we were just recapping shit. I guess besides the deadline might help her. But yeah. So then, I don't really know anything useful.
Damn.
Even though I don't actually know anything? Great. You don't have to tell me twice. I'm sure as hell not going to let that nightmare happen again.
So, じゃあ後ろを向いて一歩進みなさい.
Well, she's telling me to leave, isn't she? Oh, get out of your hair then. But if there's anything I can do, please sure to call me. Be sure to call me. You did that a lot last time. No cast me, I guess. Yes, ma'am. I'm out of here. Snoozing? New day. I think pacing wise, we should stop here. Brand new day. Seems good. Okay, so this episode was fun. Basically, we... Again, I like... We're getting a picture of how the story's gonna play out. At least for the beginning. Because it's gonna change, obviously. But, yeah, it is really like a Higurashi thing. Where, like, we have prior knowledge. And using the prior knowledge, we're trying to change the events of the future. It is... Again, also kind of cool to see, like, you know, Takeru as the special cadet, and he actually has, like, the skills to back it up, so now no one's gonna question him, and he's gonna seem a lot more reliable. Obviously, Takeru did fill that role by the end, but from the start, I don't know, maybe it'll change a lot. Again, I don't know how they're gonna graduate faster, because they do the test, then they do the TSF training, then they graduate, so I guess if everyone's better at the TSFs, like, faster, they'll graduate faster, if that's how it works. I don't know. I guess we'll have to see. But thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time on more Muv Luv Unlimited. Later.